Now, here's meteorologist Michelle Muscatello with your live Pinpoint Doppler 12 futurecast.
One of my neighbors is a teacher, actually a couple are, but I talked to one this morning, and she's not too happy that she hasn't had a chance to enjoy her first full week of vacation at the beach, which is where she likes to usually go.
She's not alone.
No.
I'm hearing complaints everywhere I go, and rightfully so. I mean, it is cloudy, it's damp, it's cool, but we're almost at the end, Pat.
Okay.
All right, we've got another dreary afternoon. There's not a lot of showers and thunderstorms out there right now, but I do expect things to change as the evening wears on. In the first half of the night, at least, the threat of some scattered showers and storms. City cam over Providence right now. The skies are gray. The temperatures, they've only warmed a few degrees from this morning. 66 right now. It's that northeasterly wind that's driving in the damp and cool ocean air. It's kept a little bit of mist around. And look how chilly it is in Boston. Only 60 degrees. 62 right now in Plymouth. We're at 66 in Providence. Only 61, though, in Smithfield and Worcester State in the 50s. 65 for Westerly in Newport and about 67 right now in New Bedford. Caitlin in Warwick reporting 66. She says it's a cloudy and gloomy day. And Jim says it's overcast and damp at his house, only 59. So we're all stuck with this raw and dreary weather. They do have some sunshine off to our west, but look what's happened in the sun. Scattered showers, thunderstorms firing up all across Pennsylvania, New York, New Jersey now. And all of that is going to start to shift to the east. So for the afternoon, we'll start to see it arrive in Connecticut and western Mass and then push into southeastern New England by this evening. It's happening along this slow-moving storm system. This front is stalled to our south. Now, finally, we'll see a change tonight. It's going to lift through as a warm front, and that'll allow our temperatures to be a little bit milder as we head into the daytime Saturday, even though we're still forecasting that chance of a shower or thunderstorm. All right, so upper 60s at 3 o'clock, lots of clouds around. A shower should hold off until, again, later in the evening. Mist and a possible shower for the trip home from work in the 60s still, and then later on tonight, a round of showers and thunderstorms possible for most areas as temperatures drop back down to about 60 by dawn tomorrow morning. So here's that futurecast starting tomorrow. I want to show you if you're planning on going down to Newport for the flower show or perhaps the air show at Quonset, we are looking at the threat of a scattered shower or thunderstorm. Now, better chance is going to be in the afternoon. This is 7:30 in the morning, so still can't rule out a passing shower, but there will also be some periods of hazy sun in there and some dry time too, so it's not a washout, but if you have one of the events to go to, you'll want to plan for maybe dodging a quick shower. 67 Newport for today, 68 Hope Valley, cloudy, cool, that late day shower, northern suburbs highs in the mid 60s, Burrillville and Foster Center, mist and drizzle, just a raw day, and it's cool in New Bedford, only about 68. Some evening showers possible, Middletown, Seekonk at about 69. So visibility on the bay is poor, northeast winds at 5 to 10 knots, and it's definitely not a great beach day for doing any sunbathing. Here's how it's looking for the air show this weekend. We're looking at, again, warmer temperatures for Saturday, 78 with that shower or thunderstorm, 81 with sunshine on Sunday. And if you like the 80s, it looks like we've got a stretch of days where we will be in the 80s and an opportunity to get some beach time in there, especially second half of the weekend. And then for early next week, another chance of showers Tuesday night into Wednesday. But looking ahead to the extended period, I don't see any more of these storm systems, you know, through next weekend that would suggest that we'd have day upon day of dreariness and cool temperatures.
Next time I'd like to see 60s is like October.
I'm with you.
All right. Thanks, Michelle.